Hi everyone, this is Sarfaraz from Aristotle Prep, and we are looking at question 100 from the OG13 Critical Reasoning chapter. So it says, the average amount of overtime per month worked by an employee in the manufacturing division of the Hagelett Corporation is 14 hours. Okay, the average overtime is 14 hours. Most employees of the Hagelett Corporation work in the manufacturing division. Okay. Furthermore, the average amount of overtime per month worked by any employee in the company generally does not fluctuate much from month to month. Okay. Therefore, each month, most employees of the Hagelett Corporation almost certainly work at least some overtime. Okay. So the argument says that the average amount of overtime worked by employees in manufacturing division is 14 hours, and most employees work in the manufacturing division. Therefore, the next statement is useless actually, so I'm coming to the conclusion directly. Therefore, each month, most employees of Hagelett Corporation almost certainly work at least some overtime. I don't see the connection. See, it says the average amount worked by an employee in the manufacturing division of Hagelett is 14 hours. Does not mean every employee, and okay, I agree that most employees work in the manufacturing division at Hagelett. That is fine. But from the first sentence, that the average amount is this much, we can't conclude that most of the employees or all the employees are actually working overtime. It's possible that half the employees or even maybe more are not working any overtime, and the other half is working much more than 14 hours overtime, which brings the average to 14 hours. The point is, from the average that's given to us, we can't make a conclusion about the entire population. If I say the average score of students in my class is 700, that does not mean that every student is getting a 700 or most students are getting a 700. It's possible that most actually get a 620 and some get an 800, which pulls up the average to 700. So that is the problem that I have discovered in this particular argument. I haven't even seen the question stem yet. The question stem is, the debater's argument is most vulnerable to criticism on which of these grounds? You have to find a flaw in the argument. And the flaw definitely is that the average does not mean everyone. So let's look at the options. A says, it takes for granted that the manufacturing division is a typical division of the corporation with regard to the average amount of overtime its employees work each month. How does it matter? I mean, most employees do work in this particular division. The question is whether the average overtime worked by an employee applies to all employees, most employees, or not. That A doesn't help us. B says, it takes for granted that if a certain average amount of overtime is worked each month by each employee of the Hagelett Corporation, then approximately the same amount of overtime must be worked each month by each employee of the manufacturing division. But why? It never takes any such thing for granted. The only thing it takes for granted is the fact that average means most or all. C says, it confuses a claim from which the argument's conclusion about Hagelett Corporation would necessarily follow with a claim that would follow from the argument's conclusion only with a high degree of probability. It's as confusing an option you will come across. So I'll come back to it. Let's hold on to it. If I were doing the question, I would just not read it again. I'll just hold on and see. If I don't find a better option, I would go with C. If I find a better option, something what I have in mind, then I wouldn't bother with C. C is confusing, the way it's worded. D says, it overlooks the possibility that even if, on average, a certain amount of overtime is worked by members of some group, many members of that group may work no overtime at all. Perfect. That is the answer, actually. I'll go back and look at C, but D definitely is the answer. E says, it overlooks the possibility that even if most employees of the corporation work some overtime each month, any one employee may work no overtime. But one employee will not make a difference because the conclusion is for most employees. So going back to C, now C says it confuses a claim from which the argument's conclusion would necessarily follow. But what claim are they talking about? I didn't see any such claim in the argument. The argument actually gives you a fact that the average amount is 14 hours, which is a fact. So actually, I don't even see a claim now. And as I said, D looks like the perfect answer. It matches our prediction perfectly. So just because C looks confusing, don't actually waste time on it. if you could not find, or if we could not find any other option, then I would have gone back. If I had time, I would have looked at C. If I did not have time, I would have just marked C as the answer. But we could find an answer which we had in mind, which is option D. So let's not waste too much time on option C. It's a tricky argument, maybe. On a scale of 1 to 5, I would give this one a 4. Have a nice day.